Speaker of Parliament Anita Among has reaffirmed Parliament's commitment to enact a law against counterfeits. Speaking yesterday at the Anti-Counterfeits Expo, Among said that counterfeits not only harm people but also cause revenue and economic distortions.
Everyone is a victim, whether in terms of cows are victims, human beings are victims. Everything is a victim. It shouldn't be actually everyone. Everything is a victim of counterfeit. Because it is out of this counterfeit that you'll find people are getting cancer out of counterfeit. People are getting sick. The cows are dying.
Speaker Among toured the stalls during the expo at Parliament as part of a campaign by Bujiri Municipality MP Asuman Basalirwa to consult players in the manufacturing sector on his private member's bill on counterfeits.
We lose a lot of money in terms of finances and health to a tune of 2.3 trillion globally, and which is a very bad thing for our country.
Nothing addresses the aspect of counterfeit. In fact, you don't have even any law here that defines what a counterfeit is. It's strange. So we thought that there's a very big lacuna, there's a very big mischief that needs to be addressed.
In July 2023, Basalirwa, who is also the Justice Forum Party President, secured leave of Parliament to introduce the bill titled the Anti-Counterfeit Bill 2023. The bill seeks to ban counterfeit goods that infringe on intellectual property rights, focusing on copyrights and trademarks. It also introduces penalties for trading in counterfeit products and grants authority for confiscation to the Uganda Revenue Authority and inspectors from the Uganda National Bureau of Standards. The proposed punishment is 10 years, whereas previous penalties were only 2 years or a fine of 2 million shillings. 7 senior 4 candidates from different schools in Bale City, among the score others who were arrested in the wee hours of a police operation to crack down on criminal gangs that have been terrorizing residents in the suburbs of Bale City. In an operation led by Kenneth Bakashava, the DPC, during the early hours of Tuesday, police conducted an intelligence-led operation at 2 a.m. in Bale Northern City Division, targeting areas notorious for criminal activity. He confirmed that several suspected criminal gangs that had staged illegal roadblocks to rob unsuspecting business people were arrested, and among them were 7 senior 4 candidates who he declined to disclose identities. He also revealed that operations started in the areas of Muni, Chikamba, Mutoto, and spread it to Mission Cell, Busamaga, and Mutukula. He said those arrested are currently being held at police stations pending further screening and interrogations. Kenya's Senate yesterday launched the impeachment trial of Deputy President Rigathi Gachagua after the embattled politician lost yet another court bid to stop the process. In a historic move last week, the lower house of parliament, the National Assembly, voted overwhelmingly to impeach Gachagua on 11 charges, including corruption and abuse of office. The 59-year-old has denied all the allegations and will continue to serve in his role until the Senate decides whether to approve his removal. The upper house began meeting last week but started examining the motion yesterday, initially behind closed doors. A decision is expected late on Thursday. A total of 282 MPs in the 349-member National Assembly on October 9th voted to impeach Gachagua, more than two-thirds required.
Your Excellency, regarding Gachagua, how do you plead to ground 1, guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
Ground 2,
fairly long.
His Excellency the Deputy President, if you may, you may sit, and when taking the plea, you may stand.
No, Mr. Speaker, let me stand.
The motion accused him of corruption, insubordination, undermining the government, and practicing ethnically divisive politics, among a host of other charges. Unlike the process in the lower house where MPs voted on the entire motion, senators will consider each separate charge in what is expected to be a lengthy examination of the accusations facing the deputy president. Gachagua, who was attending Wednesday's session on his defense, will have an opportunity to cross-examine his accusers as well as present opening and closing statements according to the Senate's order of business.